Commitment, courage, endurance, devilry, valor and sacrifice find their identity in the tradition of the armed forces. If a spirit of adventure and toughness enthuse the forces, in the same way, Wiilyz has also been a part of the same culture and tradition. Because of the same spirit of adventure and toughness, it has distinguished itself as reliable, sporty, and everlasting mechanic beauty. Though the company was founded in 1908 by John Billy, the real journey for it started in year 1941, when War Department of USA sought a lightweight truck which could withstand the tough conditions of the battlefield. This challenge was taken by Wiilyz Overland Motors. The company had survived many bankrupt situations in its earlier period, but was well renowned for its design and engineering. Wiilyz 77, a four-cylinder engine sedan, was one of the successful models before they gained popularity with MBs and CJs, better known as military jeep and civilian jeep. The company produced more than 6.5 lakh jeeps for the military use only. After the World War II, Wiilyz decided to resume the commercial production under the same brand Wiilyz. This was very unusual for the public to travel in such a sturdy vehicle. It was not a surprise that it was positioned as a substitute to farm tractors. This first commercial model, CJ-2A, soon gained popularity among the farmers, ranchers, hunters and others who needed a lightweight vehicle for use on unimproved roads and trails. It was first of its kind in commercial vehicle category, which was a four-wheel drive. Later on, it went on to produce a series of CJs which became more popular with times. In India, Jeep has been very famous with army and youth. This has become a symbol of liberty, toughness and adventure. People enjoyed taking a ride in the open markets and love to go to adventurous places on long journeys. Although some Indian companies launched models in the same line of Jeep, but Jeep has maintained its charm and youthfulness. Mandi Dabwali, a small town situated in the border area of Haryana, Punjab and Rajasthan, has become the center of attraction for assembling and customizing the Wiilyz look-like. It is India's largest market for producing jeeps nothing but from the scratch. The town has developed itself as a marketplace for Wiilyz jeeps. Everything from assembling, customizing to the finished product is done within this area. There are 8 showrooms here which are finally placing the gift of adventure in the customers' hands from all over India. This has become a completely unorganized automobile industry which has thrived on desi talent and skills. An unorganized automobile industry? That to people running it without any professional degrees, courses or training, and desi jugaad creating own niche despite so many domestic and foreign big brands? Even we were shocked and thrilled when we heard of it for the very first time. We thought and discussed among ourselves with usual management fundas thrown at us at the institute. It looked very interesting and amazing to us, and this curiosity to know more about it led us to the actual place, Mandi Dabwali. Before we were on the field, we had done our homework and prepared a blueprint of information which we were supposed to gather. We surveyed the area and met with a number of people who were very anxious at the same time to divulge information. The things which were bothering us were how these people are getting the required chassis since they do not have a manufacturing facility, how much is close and internal coordination, associationship among all of them and the competition, how they are managing all these internal processes and converting the waste to wealth, what's their supply chain of resources, tools and information. And what kind of marketing practices they are adopting. A finished product goes through the normal cycle of passing through many stages of processes and hands before it lands with glory at the showroom. It takes around 30 to 45 days to complete a cycle. From preparing of chassis to finally sticking stickers, it goes through more than 15 workshops, passing through more than 20 skilled and 45 helpers. It is generating a source of income for so many people, directly or indirectly. The whole story starts when it seems finished in normal circumstances. The army, after utilizing the vehicle for a number of years, realizes that it is not fit for the further use and auctions them at very low rates to the general public. People representing this market purchase this scrap and pass it on to the hands of Mandi Dabwali market, which once again blows life into the dead body through the versatile skills and resource management practices. The all body parts are discarded except the chassis, from where all the action starts. The chassis is prepared in the workshop, engine overhauling, gearbox mounting and assembling of the parts begins.
This is army.
And then it is assessed for further use. Taking into consideration the condition of the engine, repairable engines are put for overhauling, or else the engine from Jeep of damaged body is mounted onto this. In the meantime, denting and painting work is carried out by the other workers.
Okay.
Next step is remounting of the engine. After this step, various methods like compliance of checklist points and test drives are performed to confirm the reliability of the assembled Jeep. Jeeps are then customized with various types of accessories like seats, mirrors, lights, alloy wheels and other attachments as per the customer preference. Now the final product of assured quality is delivered to the showroom. Our team interviewed about 10 such dealers who are into the business of assembling customized Jeeps. Our country has thousands of unorganized businesses which remain unrecognized although their contribution is very much commended. This sector has proliferated with the requirements of people getting the finished product. But when we look through the eyes of an observer, the management of resources, information and coordination is at par with any organized industry. They have gained expertise in their assigned job, years of commitment and hard work. Mandi Dabwali is one such finest example of hard work, management and technical skills. All we need is to learn to derive uniqueness from these sectors which seem usual and monotonous to the common eye. Atal Bihari Vajpayee, Indian Institute of Information Technology and Management, has taken an initiative in this regard to recognize their efforts through this documentary. We are committed to bring these sectors to the